All right, in this video, we're going to take a look at a very popular calculus question. That is, how do I find the area under the curve of a graph? Today, we're just going to look at approximating those areas, and eventually we will be able to get the exact area. So suppose I have this nice, smooth polynomial here, and somebody said to you, look at the interval from 0 to 4, cut it into 4 equal pieces, and then use some rectangles under or around the curve to estimate area. If I was starting from the left, well, I would need to get the height of my rectangles from the y values of my function. So if I start from the left, well, the leftmost y value would be 0. And if I'm cutting this interval into 4 equal pieces, the next y value would be when x is 1, and then the next y value would be when x is 2, et cetera, et cetera. If I construct those rectangles, when y is 0, I don't have a rectangle because the height is 0. But then if I trace in the rest of those rectangles for the leftmost endpoints of those, we call those subintervals, cutting the interval into 4 equal pieces and then looking at the left endpoints of each of them. And then if I fill that in, whatever that area is of those rectangles added together would approximate the area under the curve. Now, if I did the same thing, but I started from the right-hand side, and I split that into 4 equal pieces, looked at the y values from the right endpoints, it would look something like this. And I could fill that in to get the area approximation. One other thing I could do is instead of looking at the right or left endpoints, I could maybe find the midpoints of each subinterval and then look at the heights at those x values. And I'd look at something like this, fill it in, and approximate the area of that curve. So these three things have names. That first one is LRAM, that stands for Left Riemann Approximation Method. The second one was RRAM, this is the Right Riemann Sum Approximation Method. And then the last one is called the Midpoint Method. And we'll do some practice in class how we can get these things. If you wanted to increase the accuracy, what we could do, obviously you could tell that it's not really accurate. You could look at the interval and cut it into smaller pieces and get more rectangles. And even smaller pieces and get more rectangles. That one, I guess I forgot to finish there. And then if you cut it into like an infinitely amount of rectangles and fill in the entire thing, that would give you the exact area, which we'll do later. That should give you more than enough information to get those questions on Schoology tackled.